Hello, everybody. All right, so today we're talking about exponents, laws, rules, whatever you want to call them. Let's look at this first one. We have b to the m times b to the n equals b to the m plus n. So we have like bases, b and b, same base, to the m, b to the n. So we're adding the exponents. So let's do one. 2 to the 3 times 2 to the second. Okay, we have same base, so we're going to add the exponent. 2 to the 3 plus 2 equals 2 to the fifth. Okay, all right, in the next one, we have power to power. So y to the m in parentheses to the nth power. When you have this situation, you multiply the exponents. So if we have 3 to the second in parentheses to the fourth power, that's going to equal 3 to the 2 times 4, which is going to equal 3 to the eighth power. All right, then our next example, we have division. Okay, so b to the m divided by b to the n. In this case, you're going to subtract the exponent. All right, so if we have 7 to the 4th divided by 7 to the 2nd, that's going to equal 7 to the 4 minus 2, which will equal 7 to the 2. Okay. Okay, this example, anything to the 0 power, so with a 0 as your exponent, is going to equal 1. Okay, so you have 1,000 to the 0, it's going to equal 1. You have pi to the 0, it's going to equal 1. You have 3 to the 0, it's going to equal 1. Now we can show that by demonstrating that x to 0 equals 1. Let's say we have x to the 4th over x to the 4th. Well, look back at our division law. When we have exponents, we're going to subtract. So that's going to equal x to the 4 minus 4, which is going to equal x to the 0. Or you could look at it as anything divided by itself is 1. Two ways to look at that. So x over 4, x to the 0 equals 1. All right. Okay, now let's look at when we have a negative exponent. So b to the negative n equals 1 over b to the n. So what are you doing? You're taking the taking the reciprocal, you're putting a 1 in the numerator, you're moving b to the negative n to the denominator, and you're changing the sign to positive. So b to the negative n is 1 over b to the n. Now, just the opposite if it's in the denominator. 1 over b to the negative n, we're going to move it to the numerator, change it to positive, and put it over 1. So 1 over b to the negative n becomes b to the n over 1, which becomes b to the n. Okay? All right, so let's say if we have 7 to the negative 3. Okay? So 7 to the negative, we look over here, and we're going to put a 1 over it. We're going to move the 7 to the negative 3 to the denominator, and we're going to change it to a positive. So 7 to the negative 3 will equal 1 over 7 to the 3rd. All right, let's say we have 1 over 6 to the negative 4. Okay, so we look over here. When we have a negative exponent, we're going to move it to the numerator. So 6 to the 4th over 1. Okay. And lastly, I want to show you the quotient rule. A over B to the nth power is equal to a to the n over b to the n. So if we have 1 half to the 3rd, it's going to equal 1 to the 3rd over 2 to the 3rd, which will equal 1 over 8. All right, now let's do a few more problems using these rules. Okay, 5 to the 4th times 5 to the negative 1. Okay, so we're going to add 4 and negative 1, and we'll get 5 to the 3rd, which will equal 125. Okay, 8 to the 7th divided by 8 to the 5th, we're going to subtract. So it's going to equal 8 to the 7 minus 5, which will equal 8 to the 2nd, which equals 64. One. Anything to the 0 power is 1. Negative 6 to the negative 2. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is put a 1 over that. We'll keep our negative 6. The negative 2 becomes a positive 2. And it's going to be 1 over 36. 2 to the negative 3 to the power of negative 2. We're going to multiply negative 3 times negative 2. We're going to get 2 to the 6th power. And 2 to the 6 equals 64. 2 to the 4th over 2 over x to the 4th. Okay, so it's going to be 2 to the 4th over x to the 4th. So 2 to the 4th is 2, 4, 8, 16 over x to the 4th. Okay? All right, let's do 5 more. Okay, negative 3 to the 3rd divided by negative 3 to the 5th. So we're looking over here. When we have division, we're going to subtract the exponents. So it's going to be negative 3 to the 3 minus 5, which would be negative 3 to the negative 2. And when we have a negative 2, we're going to change that to 1 over negative 3 to the 2nd. And then that will in turn equal 1 over 9. All right. 5 to the negative 1 times 5 to the negative 2. When we multiply same bases with exponents, we add. Okay. Multiply the same basis with exponents, we're going to add. So it's going to be 5 to the negative 1 plus negative 2 is 5 to the negative 3, which we'll put a 1 over that, and it's 5 to the 3rd, which is going to equal 1 over 125. All right, 1 over x to the negative 5. When we're dealing with negative exponents, we're going to reciprocate or move it the denominator to the numerator or numerator to the denominator. In this case, we have it in the denominator, so we're going to move it to the numerator. So this will become x to the 5th over 1, which becomes x to the 5th. All right. Here we have a power to a power. When we have a power to a power, we multiply. So we're going to multiply 6 times 5. So y to the 30, 6 times 5. All right, 1,396,500,000 to the 0 power, 1. Anything to the 0 power is 1. Okay, we have z to the 12th over 5 to the 2nd to the 2nd power. Okay, so we look over here, we have, when we have a to the b to the n, it's going to be a to the n over b to the n. So in this case, it's going to be z to the 24th over 5 to the 4th, which will equal z to the 24th over 5 to the 4th is 625. All right. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this lesson on exponents. We talked about multiplying, we add the exponents. When we have power to power, we multiply the exponents. When we have division, we subtract the exponents. Anything to the 0 power is 1. We talked about negative, we do the reciprocal, put it in the denominator. If it's in the denominator, we're going to move it to the numerator. And our division, we're going to move it out to a to the n over b to the n. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video. If you would, subscribe, hit the like button, and we'll see you on the next video. Thank you for watching.